members, I call to order its first meeting, the Subcommittee to Study Population Policy and Initiatives. Thank you all for your trust for allowing me to be the chairman of this subcommittee. Agenda item 1, election of deputy chairman. The secretariat has issued a notice notifying members that only one valid nomination was received by the close of nomination for the deputy chairmanship. The member nominated was Ms. Eunice Yong. She was nominated by me, and the nomination was seconded by Ms. Judy Chen. According to the Appendix 4 of the House Rules, I have to consult members on whether you are in favor of the election of the deputy chairman. I see that you all agree that Ms. Eunice Yong is elected as the deputy chair of the subcommittee. Congratulations, Eunice. Agenda item 2, schedule of meetings and items for discussion. Members are invited to suggest items for discussion for future meetings. Members may refer to the terms of reference and the work plan of this subcommittee considered by the House Committee in June 2023. Those who wish to speak may press the request to speak button. The Secretariat will take note of the topic suggested by members. Ms. Doreen Kong, 2 minutes. Chairman, I have looked at the work plan of this subcommittee. I think it covers a broad scope. Perhaps in the first few meetings, we can invite the administration to talk about our population policy after 2015. I wonder if there are any new ideas or suggestions or improved policies suggested by the administration. The administration may be able to provide information in this regard. I also hope that the administration would provide more updated statistics and tell us what kind of risks we are facing. I've looked at practices in other places. Apart from looking at the statistics, they look at whether there is a need to have reform. They also look at the impartiality in terms of the distribution of resources and whether there are any behavioral change of people in these places. Thank you, Chairman. Thank you, Ms. Kong. Mr. Chen Xiuhong, on the terms of reference, the first line says it is to comprehensively review Hong Kong's population policy, formulate short, medium, and long-term measures to address the challenges brought by changes in demographic structure. We think that this subcommittee plays a very important role. Now that this subcommittee has been set up, I think there is a negative tone in the terms of reference. That is, we have to tackle challenges brought by changes in demographic structure. I think more importantly, to address the challenges, we have to think about what are the best policies that would support the development of Hong Kong into 8 centers in the long run. Well, what I'm saying is that we should not see these as problems or challenges. We should see this as an opportunity. We should adopt a more proactive approach or optimistic approach as we discuss this topic. In 2015, the government announced its population policy. In light of the latest circumstances and changes, we should formulate new policies. It's been many years since the government last rolled out the population policy in 2015. We should review our population policy from time to time. The government in various occasions said it has no plan to carry out another population survey. However, in 2022, the Secretary for Labor and Welfare said there were 50 measures recommended in the population policy, and all these measures have been implemented. However, the government has not evaluated the effectiveness of these measures. I think this subcommittee has to urge the government to comprehensively assess the measures recommended by the population policy. On point 6 of the work plan, that is to encourage childbirth, we may offer a maternity allowance or offer tax concessions. I understand that the government stance is that there are various factors leading to the decline of childbirth in Hong Kong. But at the same time, we should implement family-friendly measures to encourage childbirth. Well, my view is that I hope the government will tell us the latest progress in terms of its implementation of family-friendly measures to show us how it's been encouraging childbirth in Hong Kong. Mr. Tang Fei, I have 2 points to make. Point 3 of the work plan, I think we may have to adjust the wording here. It says, based on the demographic study, we have to understand the future needs of INT, and we have to improve STEAM education. Well, you see that in Singapore, AI education is provided as a universal type of education. I don't think AI education has a direct relation with our demographic structure, because we have to promote AI education anyway. Rather, I think we have to look at how we can better plan our education based on manpower needs. Before the handover of Hong Kong, we had an education and manpower coordinator. And manpower and education were being looked at together. So I wonder if we can resume this position so that we can link up again education and manpower as we look at how we can improve our population policy. Dr. Chow Man Kong. Thank you, Chairman. I think it is crucial that we set up this subcommittee because we are faced by a decline of childbirth and also mismatch of demographic structure or distribution. We're also seeing an aging society. Points 2 and 3 under the work plan are important, and point 5 was also touched on by other panels and subcommittees. I think we should focus on a few areas. I think when the government is going to conduct survey on our demographic structure, it should focus on a few areas. For instance, we are seeing imported labor. We are seeing incoming talents. We should assess these talent admission schemes or labor importation schemes to see if we are achieving our expectations and goals. Thank you. Mr. Dennis Leung. Thank you, Chairman. There are 9 points covered under the work plan. Some of them overlap with the work plan of other panels or subcommittees. We should focus on looking at our population policy. For instance, should we discuss our housing policy when we looked at the decline of birth rate? Also, we encourage investors to come to Hong Kong through our immigration policies. How can we attract investors to come to Hong Kong to improve the demographic structure of Hong Kong? Should this be discussed by the subcommittee? Also, on education. On one hand, we want to build Hong Kong into an international education hub. On the other, we should look at the number of school places available. I wonder if we should discuss these as well in this subcommittee. Also, in terms of the mutual recognition of education or academic qualifications between Hong Kong and the mainland. We should look at how we can align our qualification frameworks with that of the mainland. Deputy Chair, Ms. Eunice Yong. Members mentioned that in 2015, the government promulgated the population policy strategies and initiatives. It's been some years now since the promulgation of such policy. I hope the government can tell us which areas it would focus on in terms of implementing these policies and initiatives. Well, the chief executive mentioned that the population policy promulgated in 2015 is not entirely out of date. However, we're seeing a change in demographic structure in Hong Kong as well as manpower needs. We should strive to develop ourselves into 8 centers. And how can we do that? We haven't really touched on it through our population policies. Well, point one of the work plan mentioned about manpower issues. There have been discussions about how we can attract talents to address manpower issues in Hong Kong. I want to know what policies the government are going to roll out to retain these talents. The Steering Committee on Population Policy has disbanded. It was led by relevant secretaries back then. I want to know which government bureaus or department is going to head the discussion of this particular subcommittee. Will, for instance, the Chief Secretary for Administration lead the discussion of this subcommittee? I know each government department and bureau has its responsibility to improve our policy in terms of population planning. I just want to know which government department or bureau will drive the discussion. Mr. Gary Zhang.
Thank you, Chairman.
In terms of our demographic profile, apart from looking at the age and the job distribution, I want to know the demographic profile by district. For instance, in implementing or taking forward the Northern Metropolis project as well as the Kao Yu Chao Artificial Islands project, we made reference to some statistics. There may be a significant drop of population in some districts. And I want to know if we're able to cope with this demographic change, and I think we should discuss it in this subcommittee.
Does any other member wish to speak? Mr. Porter. Chairman, sorry, I haven't had a chance to read the work plan and the terms of reference in detail. I caught a glance of the terms of reference. There appears to be no reference to the large-scale immigration that has to do with the population policy. People come here, but there are also people who have left. Whether we like it or not, quite a number of people, especially among our middle class, those in their middle ages, those middle-aged families choose to live elsewhere, out of Hong Kong. So that may have an impact on our population. So should we also look at that here? Thank you. So let's see if there's any other member who wishes to speak. If not, so will our secretary please note the comments from members. Some members argued we should follow up on the study back in 2015. We will need a framework kind of study. So we will cover those areas in talking to the government departments in our first couple of meetings. We haven't fixed a date for the next meeting yet. The secretariat will issue a notice to members. Any other business? No other business. With that, I will conclude the meeting. Thank you.